हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट न्यूमोकॉकस और स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस निमोनिया। यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली। स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस निमोनिया इज अ कैप्सुलेटेड ग्राम पॉजिटिव कॉकाई विच आर अरेंज इन पेयर्स और ऑल्सो नोन एज डिप्लोकोकस। सो टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मॉर्फोलॉजी, कल्चरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, पैथोजेनेसिस एंड लैब डायग्नोसिस ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस pneumonia. So first the morphology. So as you can see in this picture, and like I said, they are lanceolate shaped cocci. Lanceolate means they are slightly flame shaped. You can see they are not exactly round. They are slightly elongated. That's what I am trying to mean by lanceolate or flame shaped. And you can see all of them are in pairs. So they are all gram positive. You can see the violet color. They are all gram positive diplococci. Diplococci because they are all in pairs. So pneumococcus is a diplococcus, and earlier it was officially known as Diplococcus pneumoniae. Later it was put into the genus Streptococcus, and the name was the new name was Streptococcus pneumoniae. Now these are capsulated, so they have a capsule and they are non-sporing and non-motile. These are non-motile bacteria, and of course they have capsule. Capsule cannot be demonstrated here in the gram stain picture, but the negative staining will show the capsules that are produced by these organisms. A special test called the Quellen's test is done, where you know the anti-capsular antibodies are given so that the capsule is swelled, and once the capsule has swollen it can be easily appreciated under the microscope. Now coming to the cultural characteristic of this bacteria, so on blood agar, first of all, because this is a very important fastidious organism, so definitely whatever medias we will talk about in under this topic will all be enriched medium, because they cannot grow on basic medium. So this is a picture of blood agar, wherein you can see the colonies of Streptococcus pneumoniae. So you can see on blood agar they have not given a very clear lysis. They have given a partial lysis, and partial lysis is the alpha lysis. So on blood agar they give a zone of alpha lysis. You can see alpha hemolysis everywhere. So this is the picture. Then also, if the colony is older, if the colony is more than 24 hours old, 24 to 48 hours old, what you see here is these colonies are new colonies or very young colonies. But here you see these are older colonies, and as they get older, you see the development of this kind of pattern. This is called carom coin appearance or Drottmann appearance. This is very characteristic feature of Streptococcus pneumoniae. This, if you can see, there is a depression. There is a depression, and then again there is a center. So there is this center of the colony, and after that there is a depression. So it looks like the coins of carom, or it looks like the Drottmann cap. So this was a very characteristic feature that we could see, and that's why this name Drottmann colonies were given to the colonies of Streptococcus pneumoniae, which you see only in 24 to 48 hour old culture. And this happens because of the autolysis. This produces an autolytic enzyme, and that enzyme starts lysing the own colony. It attacks the cell wall of the bacteria, and that's why the colonies become depressed at the periphery and get this appearance of Drottmann. Now pathogenesis. So pathogenesis is categorized into three steps: colonization and invasion. The first step is that Streptococcus pneumoniae first colonizes itself or goes and get attached to the oropharynx or the epithelial cells of the pharynx. So this is very important, and after the help of this adhesin only they get themselves attached to the surface of the epithelial cells. Then comes tissue destruction. Once they have attached themselves with the help of their cell wall component like teichoic acid, peptidoglycan and phosphorylcholine, they start the destruction of the tissue. Avoidance of opsonization and phagocytosis. So I already told you that they have a capsule. So because of the presence of this capsule, it contributes to its pathogenicity and it helps them get away with the phagocytosis. So they cannot be phagocytosed by the macrophages. So because of the capsule that is inhibited. Now clinical symptoms. Clinical symptoms of Streptococcus pneumonia. So first is pneumonia. So it is one of the major causes of bacterial pneumonia, lobar or broncho pneumonia. Then meningitis. This also causes meningitis in mainly in the children. And after meningitis, it is also seen to cause pneumonia and bacteremia. That is the presence of this bacteria in the blood. It can be seen. Sinusitis and otitis media. So it can cause severe sinusitis and can infect the ears also, and in the ear they can lead to otitis media. Then bacteremia. So you can see bacteremia, that is the presence of this organism in the blood. So people with meningitis will definitely have pneumococcal pneumonia, and sometimes they will develop bacteremia also. Now comes the laboratory diagnosis. So in case of laboratory diagnosis, first step is the specimen collection. So this organism is mostly confined to the respiratory tract. So the most common samples are sputum, endotracheal aspirate, bronchoalveolar lavage, CSF in case of meningitis, pleural fluid, joint fluid, abscess. And you can collect blood also for blood culture in order to rule out or diagnose bacteremia. In case of microscopy, we make the smear from the sample collected and we will see if Streptococcus pneumonia is the pathogen that is present in the sample. We will see lanceolate shape. Lanceolate means the typical flame shape that we talked about in the first slide. So we'll see the lanceolate shaped or flame shaped cocci arranged in pairs, which are gram positive, and the shape is very characteristic of Streptococcus pneumonia. So as soon as you see something like that, you can say that this is Streptococcus pneumonia, and the physician can also start the preliminary treatment. But again, you have to be very experienced and you have to separate it from the normal diplococci, non-pneumococcal diplococci. So you have to be experienced for that. You have to look for that characteristic lanceolate shape of the cocci. Then next is the culture. So for culture, like I said, these are fastidious organisms. So we select enriched media, most commonly blood agar. And on the blood agar, it gives a very tiny size of colonies, like 0.5 millimeter colonies, round, translucent and mucoid. Mucoid because of the presence of the capsule. And of course, you will see alpha hemolysis, which is partial hemolysis on the blood agar. Now, how do we do identification? So once you have plated the sample on the media, have the growth, and just now we discussed how it will look like on blood agar. It will have it will give you alpha hemolysis, there will be mucoid colonies. So after that, that is not enough or sufficient to conclude that it is Streptococcus pneumonia. So for that, you have to do certain identification or confirmatory test to tell that this is Streptococcus pneumonia and not alpha hemolytic streptococci other than pneumonia. So the first test that you need to do is the Optokin sensitivity test. So Streptococcus pneumonia is known to be sensitive to Optokin, 5 microgram disc of Optokin. If it is placed on a plate and where the organism is streaked, you can see in the picture. This is the organism here, this Streptococcus pneumonia, and the disc is placed here. And around the disc, you can see that there is no growth of the organism, which indicates that this is this organism is sensitive to this drug optocin. So in order to differentiate pneumococci from other alpha hemolytic streptococcus, this is one of the most important tests that has to be done. If it was other alpha hemolytic streptococci and not streptococcus pneumonia, you will see growth around the near the disc also. And if it is pneumococci or streptococcus pneumonia, you will see this zone of inhibition around the disc. So here in this picture, it is pneumococci, so you can see this zone of inhibition. Next, very important and the gold standard test for the confirmation of streptococcus pneumonia is the bile solubility test. So what happens is, here in this we test whether the organism is soluble in bile or not. The bile which we use here is 10% sodium deoxycholate. So basically what we do is we make suspension in one tube. Okay, here you can see two tubes, that is that I will explain later. Just imagine we make there is one tube, and we make the suspension of the organism in one tube and then divide it into two tubes. The reason why we make the suspension in one tube because we want both the tubes to have the same turbidity. If you do this separately, there can be some technical errors and the turbidity on both may vary. That's why it's always wise to make the suspension in one and then divide into two. Now one is your control and one is your test. In the test, you put 10% sodium deoxycholate, 1 to 2 drops. As soon as you put this, if it is streptococcus pneumonia, it will immediately become clear. Okay, so you see here we have two tubes. This is not streptococcus pneumonia and this was streptococcus pneumonia. Now this tube was looking like this, but as soon as both were looking like this only, if you see this tube, okay, this is very turbid, this is clear. So earlier, before performing this test, both the tubes were like this only, turbid. But when you added sodium deoxycholate on this tube, it immediately became clear, because the bile helps the autolytic enzyme to break down the cells. So as soon as you added bile, the autolytic enzyme of streptococcus pneumonia broke down the cell wall and all the cells were nice. So you see clearance. Whereas here it is not streptococcus pneumonia, so even if you added bile, you see no change. So this is a very important test called bile solubility test. You can see here also in my slide, it is written clearing of the tube or loss in the turbidity in the presence of deoxycholate due to disruption of the cell. So as soon as you put the sodium deoxycholate, you will see clearing. That is the indication of streptococcus pneumonia. And after putting sodium deoxycholate also, if you don't see any clearing and the turbidity is still there, that means it is not streptococcus pneumonia. This is the most important confirmatory test. If you have culture supportive of streptococcus pneumonia and even the optocin is sensitive, but your bile solubility is showing negative result, then it cannot be streptococcus pneumonia. That's why it's called the gold standard test. And in any case, the report of bile solubility must be used as the final report. So this is very important. And also, since it is done manually, you have to be very careful with the errors that can happen. That's why I told you that the initial suspension must be made in one tube and then distributed, so that you have uniform turbidity in both. So this was the bile solubility test for streptococcus pneumonia. So that is all about streptococcus pneumonia. It's a very interesting topic. Let's just quickly summarize. So streptococcus pneumonia are gram-positive cocci, which are always seen in pairs. They are also known as diplococcus. They have this characteristic lanceolate shape. On blood agar, they show alpha hemolysis, and if the colonies are old, from 24 to 48 hours, you'll see the characteristic carom coin appearance due to autolysis of the cell. Then, coming to the clinical symptoms, so pneumonia, meningitis, sinusitis, otitis media, bacteremia are some common clinical symptoms that are seen. and then you have laboratory diagnosis. For laboratory diagnosis, you have to do microscopy culture, and after that the confirmatory tests like optic insensitivity, for which Streptococcus pneumoniae is sensitive and very important, bile solubility test that has to be done. Only when the bile solubility is showing the desired result, the bile soluble, if the organism is bile soluble, the report, that's how it is interpreted, bile soluble. If you see the clearing, that indicates it's bile soluble. So only if it is bile soluble, you can conclude that it is Streptococcus pneumonia. So that was my class on Streptococcus pneumonia. Please go back to your textbook, read about this, and you will be welcome for your confusions. I can clear your doubts. You can post your questions. Thank you so much.